I just want to, before I start, I want to thank Gonzalez and her art students for making these beautiful Japanese scenes and vases. I think they're absolutely wonderful. Time for that. I'd like to thank all the staff and the administration because we just had a crazy schedule trying to get here and taking classes from different kids, and they were very flexible, and I really appreciate that as well. Now, looking at your program, don't freak out. You are not going to be here for 4 hours. Okay, there is 36 performances, but they average about, 2 minutes. So anyway. Now, I decided last night that I thought, you know what? I know I'm going to have to make a speech, and I thought, I better do it in the beginning while I have this nervous energy, because believe it or not, when I'm down there, I play every piece that the kid comes up in my head. I can see the music. So about an hour, I'm exhausted, and my emotions are, all over the place. So bear with me just a few more moments. First, I want to say I'm an extremely lucky person. I've always been lucky, and that's not a brag. It's really the truth. Things seem to, fall in my lap. I've been extremely lucky in my position here at Franklin. I'd like to thank all the staff, the families, and the thousands of students that have crossed the doors of Franklin while I've been working here. First as a music teacher, I was the chorus teacher, and then eventually the piano teacher. I've been so lucky to work with some amazing fine arts educators all these years, and the current team is truly first class. Franklin is a very special place. I would have given anything as a kid to have attended here. When I was 12, my family moved to Texas, from Texas to a small town in southern Illinois, like around Missouri-Kentucky border, really far south, southern Illinois. That was where my mother was from. I didn't feel very lucky then. But as it turned out, it really was a stroke of luck, because I met two amazing women there. First was my music teacher in junior high and high school. Her name is Leah Sims. She was the first one to really say, wow, you've got a great voice. You should be singing. And then also the second one was my piano teacher, who was instrumental in pushing me to apply to be a music major in college. I can't believe how lucky I was that these two women, these two amazing women, were in this tiny little town. But they were, and they took me under their wing. Last November, I flew to Texas to see my mother. It was her birthday. She turned 83. She has since moved back to Texas from southern Illinois, and we started talking about the first piano I ever had. Now, this was probably 77, 78. Now, I know half this room wasn't even born in 1978, or had never seen it. But I wanted a piano, and this was before, Casios or electric keyboards. You couldn't just order it from Amazon or Target and go pick up something. If you wanted piano lessons, you had to have a piano. Now, my mother was a single mother. She had four children. So that was a big ticket item, but I was very persuasive. As much as I could be. Now, we did finally find one, and it was for $50. Now, it may not seem a lot, but as a single mom with four kids in 1978, $50 was a lot to spend on a piano, especially this broken down thing that we found for $50. It was in a garage somewhere, and it had been in a tavern. There were little cigarette burns all over it, where some honky-tonk player just, kind of put it out there and let it rest while they played the piano. I mean, it was painted horribly ugly, brown. But my mother bought it. We took it home, and my mother painted it glossy, glossy white. It must have taken five coats. It must have been. And the front panel, because it was not bright, and the bottom panel, she wallpapered. Gold wallpaper with flock design, where it's raised a little bit with a little fuzzy. This is the 1970s now. So, things were a little loose as far as decoration. I loved it. She loved it. Only Elton John and Barry Manilow had white pianos. So, anyway, I'm so glad that she did that. I'm sure, I'm not positive, but I'm sure she looked at her four children one day and said, one of these things is not like the others. That's me. And now, my family was not musical at all. And so I don't know, they just weren't. But I was, because of those wonderful teachers. I've always felt that one of the best qualities of being a performer, other than talent, for any performer, like saying you're a singer or an actor or a comedian, and even a teacher, one of the best qualities, besides talent, one of the best qualities is knowing when to leave the stage. It is my time. It is my time. It is. But don't worry, because I'm a lucky person. And I'm also a Sagittarius, so there's a stage waiting for me somewhere, always. I don't know what it's going to look like. I don't know what it's going to be. But I know it's going to be mine, and whatever I choose to make of it. I want to thank you, Franklin, because I am so lucky to have been a part of this school. It's been amazing. I hope I haven't stayed too long. All right, enough of this adult nonsense. These kids have been waiting for a few months now. So we're gonna start, first off, with eighth grader Cara Daniels. She's doing a wonderful piece called Prelude to the Dance.
Elijah Newby.
He is playing a jazz piece called A Neat Beat. This is his second year of piano. Let's give him a hand. Next up is seventh grader Nola Bell. She is going to be doing a lovely piece called Smooth Sailing. Next up is seventh grader Ivan Cho. He's doing a piece called Carnival. Next up is Donovan and Harper. This is their first year of playing the piano, and they have a duet called the Blue Danube Waltz.
All right.
Thank you.
All right, another duet is coming up. This is Genesis and Anthony, and they're doing Bouncin' Boogie. Next up is Julia Mendoza. He is in eighth grade. This is only his second year of piano. He's got a nice ballad called Ballad for Amy. All right, next up is seventh grader Chase, and he's doing a great piece called Excalibur. Thank you. right, and now we have eighth grader Ayuk. This is his second year in piano, and he's doing a jazz tune called Take It From Here. Making their debut in the piano recital, the fourth grade. Come on out, fourth grade. Their second piece is called An End of a Lovely Day, and we're all set. Count you out. One, two. Thank you. next up is seventh grader Jordan Rollins. She's doing a jazz piece called Waltz in Blue. Next is Matthew, who's in seventh grade, and he's doing Beach Buggy Boogie. Next up is seventh grader Isabella Vaca. She has a nice jazz piece called Faraway Waltz. Next up is a duet, which is sixth grade. This is Nyla and Sadie, and they're doing Gypsy Serenade. Next up is another duet. This is Stormy Sea with Christopher Harris and Olivia Henderson. Next up is eighth grader Patrice Griffin, and he is doing a piece called Amen Corner. Give him a hand. Next up is Mac. He has been in piano for 2 years, and he is doing a great piece called The Gulf Stream. Give him a hand. Thank you. Next up is eighth grader Herman, and he's doing a piece, Jazz Train. Give him a hand. Next duet is sixth graders Ella and Jaya. They're doing a piece called Parisian Waltz. This is the fifth grade. Come on out, fifth grade. And give them a hand. Here we go. All right, so their first number is called Copycat. Thank you. All right, next up is seventh grader Ava Schwartz, and she's doing a beautiful piece called Rainforest Rhapsody. So let's skip ahead right now, and let's have Owen Lee come out and do energetic etude. Duet, which is called, this is Alexandra and Clay, and they're doing Blackberry Rag.
go.
All right, next up is seventh grader Caden Miller, and he's doing a piece called The Stranger. Next up is eighth grader Jacob Rose. He is doing a great piece called Low Sea Boogie. Next up is two sixth graders, Adela and Vivian. They're doing a piece called Swirling Winds. Thank you. next up is eighth grader Annika. She's doing a piece called A Sunday on La Grande Yacht. Next up is eighth grader Garrett, and he's doing a piece called Face to the Sun. Next up is seventh grader Molly, who's doing a piece called Illyrian Dance. Thank you. Next up is seventh grader Arianne. She's doing a piece called The Great Smoky Mountains. There she is.
Hi, Ari.
He's doing a piece called Fire Dance.
Thank you.
Way to go, Elliot. Next up is seventh grader Daniela. She's doing a piece called Rio San Rafael. Next up is seventh grader Yenna Lee. She's doing a piece entitled Storm Warning. Thank you. Next up is eighth grader Felix Higgins, and he's doing a piece called Death to Glamour. Piece for the day is Claire de Lune, and it is played by eighth grader Hermes.
Thank you.
Wow, okay. That was long, but beautiful. Let's give all our pianists a great big round of applause. Real quick, I hope the eighth graders are out there in the back. Are they? Just so I could say hello or goodbye?
They are.
They are? Well, bring them out. We gotta go. Okay. Well, this is part of the class anyway. anyway, I just want to let these eighth graders and their others, wherever they are, wish them the best of luck in high school. You're an amazing class, extremely, extremely talented, and I can't be prouder of you. So best of luck and everything. Thank you.
All right, well, Mr. Santos, you know we have some special surprises for you today, so we're going to need everybody to stick around for another 5 minutes, please. But yeah, let's give our eighth graders another round of applause. Thank you so much. All right, so while we wait for the rest of our eighth graders to come, I just had a couple of words I wanted to share about Mr. Santos. Fantastic words, Mr. Santos. Today we gather to celebrate not only our talented and wonderful students, but also the remarkable career of a teacher who has touched the lives of countless young musicians, inspired colleagues, and left an indelible mark on our school community. Mr. Santos has been inspiring students in Chicago with the gift of music for over 30 years. He has impacted the lives of not just hundreds, but thousands of young people across our city who have then gone on to be thriving young adults, young people in not just Chicago, but around the nation. As we bid farewell to Mr. Santos, his last piano recital, he's coming back after spring break, all right? This is not goodbye, Mr. Santos, but this is his last piano recital. And as we bid goodbye to him, we just want to celebrate not only the years of dedicated service, but also the profound impact that he's had on each and every one of us. So let's go give him a big round of applause. Though your presence, I have a long speech, but I'm going to cut it short because we're about to have the bell and we have many surprises. But just though your presence will be greatly missed, we take comfort knowing that you leave behind a legacy of excellence that will endure for years to come. As you embark on your new journey, may you be met with warmth, appreciation, and the love that you've shown all of us. Thank you, Mr. Santos, for everything you've done for us, and may your new chapter be filled with joy, laughter, and endless opportunities and new adventures. We love you. All right. I'm gonna turn it over to our eighth graders, but also I'm going to need Yenna and Daniela, if you're around, to come on up, and then our teachers, go ahead and come up as well. All right.
From the eighth grade class, this is just something to show you how much we appreciate you and teaching us for all these years.
Thank you for teaching. Here's some flowers, and you will be very missed. This is for you for retiring. We'll greatly miss you, and this is a card.
From the Fine Arts team and Ms. Wontor, congratulations. We love you.
All right, and let's
thank
all just...
you, thank you, thank you.
All right, one more time, let's give it up for how much we love Mr. Santos. All right. Thank you all. And that's another successful piano.